Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. In this video, we are going to cover frequency divider using IC555. It is one of the application of monostable multivibrator. We are going to see the concept and working first, and then we will solve a numerical where we will design a frequency divider by two. So it is going to be very easy to understand if you know the working of monostable multivibrator. But I will still brush up some things which are required to know for frequency division concept. Okay, so for monostable multivibrator, you have one stable state and that state is low. And when you apply a trigger pulse, that state is switched. It goes from low to high for some time and then it reverts back to low again. And please note that this is about monostable multivibrator using IC555. And when it comes to monostable multivibrator using op-amp, it is opposite. In that case, your output is always high and you have to apply trigger pulse to make it low. And here it is opposite. Here you are applying trigger pulse to make it high for some time. Okay. Another thing to note is your trigger pulse works only if your output is in stable state. Means if your output is in low state and you applied a trigger pulse over here, then only it will switch to high. Okay. But if you apply a trigger pulse when your output is already in high state, it will not matter. It will not switch its state. Okay, it will continue to be in the high state. And that time period depends upon your components, RA and C. Okay, so the circuit is going to remain same. RA and C are your main components. This is just bypass capacitor. Then here you are applying trigger pulse. Here you are collecting your output. Circuit is same. So we are familiar with these waveforms. This is trigger input, this is output waveform, and this is capacitor voltage. So whatever time your capacitor takes to reach this 2/3 VCC threshold, for that time period your output remains high. Okay, and that time period is known as TP. So our goal is to divide the frequency by 2. And we know time period is nothing but inverse of frequency. So if you divide the frequency by 2, your time period will be multiplied by 2. It will get doubled. Okay. Currently, if you see, the time period of your output waveform is equal to your time period of trigger input. Okay. Please don't get confused with this TP. TP is not your time period. TP is just T on. Okay. TP is just part of your whole time period of output. So our goal is to double this T and make it twice. So if we make it 2T, where T is nothing but the time period of your trigger input. So 2T means nothing but F by 2. Okay. Now the way to double this time period is to increase your TP than the time period of your trigger input. TP should be greater than T. So I want to keep my output high for more time. Okay, so I'm going to erase this. Now let's say our new TP is this, which is greater than time period of your input. Then it turned back to its low state. Then the third trigger is applied and then it switched back to high again. Okay, so your new TP is this, which is greater than this T. Now your capacitor voltage waveform will also change. Now your capacitor will charge like this. So you applied first trigger pulse, the output switched from low to high. Okay. The second trigger pulse applied at this point didn't make any change to your output waveform. The output continued to be high. Okay. So it skipped this pulse because it was already high. Then output came back to its stable state again, low. Then we applied third trigger pulse. So as now output is low, it turned back to high again. Okay. So even if there are 100 trigger pulse between these time period, it would not matter. The output will not change. Okay. It will skip all of them. Now, if you see the time period of output waveform, this is the time period of new output waveform, and which is nothing but 2 times of T. Okay. So if you see, there are 2 cycles of trigger input, which are covered by this single cycle of output waveform. Okay. So in this way, we divided the frequency by 2 by doubling the time period. What adjustments we did? We made TP greater than time period. So now if you want to divide the frequency by 3, then what will you do? You have to skip these two pulses. Okay. For divide by 2, you skip one pulse. Okay. Now for divide by 3, you have to skip two pulses. That means your TP should be greater than twice of T. Okay. Now I think the concept is very clear. So before moving to numerical, we will note down the equations which we need. So just now we saw, if you want to divide by 2, make TP greater than T. If you want to divide by 3, make TP greater than 2T. Okay, in this way, TP should be greater than N minus 1 times T for divide by N frequency divider. Okay, second equation we need is TP equal to 1.1 RA into C. Okay, so now let's move to numerical. Design monostable multivibrator that is to be used as frequency divider by 2 and the frequency of input trigger is 2 kHz. So the trigger pulse which we apply, it has frequency of 2 kHz. Okay, and now we have to design this whole circuit which will divide the frequency by 2. Okay, so just now we saw TP should be slightly larger than T. So let's take TP equal to 1.2 times time period. So here this T is nothing but time period of your input triggers. And we know the frequency, that is 2 kHz given in the question. So we can easily find out T just to the inverse of frequency. Okay. Now just multiply this by 1.2 and we got TP. So TP is 0.6 millisecond. So the output remains high for 0.6 milliseconds. Okay. Now we have to use this equation 1.1 RA into C. Now we got TP 0.6 millisecond. Okay, then let's assume this C as 0.01 microfarad. So to find out RA, just send this 1.1 and C to left hand side and your RA will come out as 54.5 kilo-ohms. Okay, just put this in calculator. So if your university wants standard value, then you can take any nearby value of this value. Otherwise, you can keep it as it is. The last step is you have to draw the circuit and waveforms. So you just have to write the values in the circuit RA and C. This is just a bypass capacitor. Okay. And in waveforms, you have to show this TP is 0.6 millisecond. And what was your time period of trigger input? Trigger input time period, we know the frequency. Frequency is 2 kilohertz. So the time period would be 0.5 millisecond. So as you can see, it decreased the frequency by 2. Okay. So this is how you have to design the monostable multivibrator as a frequency divider. So I hope you understood how to design a frequency divider with the help of IC555. So if you have liked this video, press the like button, share this whole playlist with your friends and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.